Good Saturday evening, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek with a quick look at your forecast for the rest of the last weekend of summer. And as of right now, pretty much exactly where you would expect it to be, hot and humid across the Mid-South as we go into the course of the next couple of days. Little, if anything, is really going to be changing anytime soon, and the chances of showers and thunderstorms, not really great chances, but they are out there. If you'd like to know more about the forecast, the 7 to 10-day forecast is available here at WREG.com/weather, or you can check out more information, again, at the red bar at the bottom of the page, where you can get more information about what's going on with the forecast as we go into the course of the rest of the next couple of days. Again, changing a little bit toward the end of this next week, and quite possibly the numbers may be dropping a little bit. If everything is holding, we might be seeing the potential of maybe some cooler weather heading our direction. And yes, I said cooler, so we may be looking at some nicer conditions there. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little bit. If you'd like to, please drop your location, city and state, and also your weather reports out there. Let's get some amateur meteorology going on. Let's see what's going on across the Mid-South area where it comes to anything involving weather across the Mid-South. And of course, if you've got anything in the way of pictures, we would love to see them so we could pass them along to everybody else. You can tweet them to me at aonic_WREG3, or you can post them on my Facebook page as well. Be glad to have them along there. We'll show you some of your web pictures coming up in just a little bit. And of course, we'll take a look at your forecast into the first few days of autumn, and that'll be coming up here in just a little bit. Record high temperatures today, not quite. It came within about 6 of that. 98, the record high, hasn't been broken since 2 years ago, and that's 98 degrees there. 92 is our high. 86 is where we should be for this time of the year. 73 above average as well on the low temperature, and a record low of, wouldn't that feel nice, 50 degrees set last back in 1904, so quite some time since that's been broken. Currently on the Ole Miss campus, what's left of sunset fading away through the trees of the Grove and off toward the Student Union. Ventress Hall and a lot of everybody else out there having some fun as the football game goes on. Temperatures are in the 80s in Oxford for this evening. Feels like 84 with, again, that 70% humidity out there. Winds out of the northeast at about 3 miles per hour for this evening, so not really cooling much of anybody off. Live picture from our transmitter tower camera, and again, looking at some of the fading sunset out there for tonight. We'll turn it around here in a little bit so we can see more of the moon and some of the planets out there. Should be able to see Jupiter, Saturn, and Mars out there. Venus is already down below the horizon, if I'm not mistaken, but you should be able to get some good stargazing in for this evening, so take a look out there. And across the river from our tower cam downtown at the Cotton Exchange camera, again, looking back toward the lights of West Memphis, Mississippi River out there in the dark, and the southern tip of Mud Island right there, seen barely in the darkness of Saturday night. So again, thanks a lot to everybody checking in for right now. Scott Jarvis, thank you for the pictures. 82 degrees, feels like 88 in Banner, Mississippi. Thank you very much for that one. Appreciate that weather report. Hot in Horn Lake, Sherilyn Pollen English. Thank you very much for that one. Rooting on the cool weather, Angie Renee Die Walgenbach. Thanks a lot for that vote for the weather out there. Muggy in Holly Springs, Pam Akins Brandon. Thank you very much. And 75 and clear in Tahoka, Texas, Carol Baker Montgomery. Thank you very much for that one. Kind of sandwiched in between systems for tonight. We've got one back out into and around the area of Texas. This was a failed tropical system. It's now not even that. It's just basically kind of a wrapped up area of low pressure, and it's just wandering around the Rio Grande Valley. Tons of rainfall from this, and it's in the perfect location, kind of like Florence, bringing tons of rainfall on shore. So anything south of Austin and down to the Rio Grande is picking up some pretty heavy rainfall. Matamoros and into the northern parts of Mexico picking up some pretty good rainfall from this system that never had a designation and never had a name. So this, again, just one of those tropical systems that just didn't make it. In the meantime, back to the east of us, and unfortunately at this point, sitting in just the wrong location at this time. Center of circulation is just north of Charleston, South Carolina. Not great news, because again, this has really held its strength over the last 24 hours, and there is little, if anything, anywhere nearby this thing to drive it forward. So it's going to be stuck here for probably about the next couple of days, which means parts of the Carolinas could be winding up with maybe another 1 to 2 feet of rainfall in the next few days, depending on how much we get. The circulation again around here, bringing tons of that tropical moisture onshore, feeding it onshore into the Carolinas, and that's again going to be washing its way all the way down. If you're in the area here in the Mid-South from the storm, taking refuge from the storm here, first of all, welcome to the area. There's a little if anything going on, so you got tons of stuff to keep you busy here. But again, if you'd like to go home, maybe you're chomping at the bit to get back on the roadway and to head back home to the Carolinas, don't go just yet, because again, you're going to be looking at some very heavy rainfall, and again, could be some dangerous conditions as this storm continues to sit in place. So again, wait until the authorities give the all clear and then go on back. But flooding, debris, roadways are going to be a problem. Again, there's got to be inspections done to see if roadways are in fact safe. It's going to be a while. So again, if you're here in the Mid-South, welcome to the area. Enjoy yourself, relax, wait for the storm to pass on through. Stay safe, more importantly than anything else, and keep it tuned to News Channel 3, and we'll keep you advised on what's going on with Florence. Meanwhile, here in the Mid-South, nothing to tell you about in the way of showers or thunderstorms. Now, if Florence, what's left of it, gets a little bit closer to us tomorrow, we may see a few speckles of rain in the eastern viewing area, but we're just not seeing too much out there, so good news there. Temperatures back in the lower to mid-80s across much of the area right now. Still feels like it's in the 90s at Memphis International and around U of M Earth Sciences, so we are looking at some pretty toasty conditions even after the sun has gone down across much of the Mid-South. Paulette Morrow, 81, clear in New Bern. Thank you very much for that one. Thanks for checking on through for right now. Libby Bledsoe, Darby, heavy police presence in Nesbitt, Hernando. I haven't heard anything, but I'll relay that on to my producers to see what's going on, if there's anything going on for right now at this point. Weather for Crenshaw, Mississippi, Santana Thompson. We'll talk about that coming up in just a little bit, so stay tuned for more there. Running the numbers into tonight, News Channel 3 at 10, temperatures back into the upper 70s to the lower 80s. Tomorrow morning, low temperatures, again, not really all that low, upper 60s to mid 70s at best. Then, tomorrow afternoon, if you remember what today was like, you got a pretty good idea what tomorrow is going to be like. Now, there is this possibility, slim though it may be, as we look back toward the east, as Florence gets a little bit closer to us, the circulation is not going to race westward, but it's going to wander that direction toward western North Carolina, eastern Tennessee. There's a possibility that we might see the potential of some of this rain and thunderstorms making its way into the Tennessee River Valley. Middle Tennessee, North Alabama will be the best place for that, but it's possible east of Dyersburg, around Corinth, down to around Tupelo, you may see some of those stray showers and thunderstorms taking place. The rest of the viewing area, Memphis, northwest Mississippi, eastern Arkansas, I really doubt we're going to be seeing too much of anything, but once again, keep it tuned and we'll keep you updated on that throughout the next few days. For tomorrow, again, almost identical to today, maybe a degree or two less, but I really think we're talking about some steamy conditions out there for the course of the next couple of days out across much in the Mid-South area for right now. Temperatures for Monday, heading back to school or work, going to be back into the lower 90s once again, and another chance of an isolated shower or thunderstorm on Tuesday with numbers staying in the lower 90s. This will be the last week of summer. We're rapidly approaching the end of the season, coming close to the equinox, which will be happening next Saturday night. So we've got about 1 week and change, a few hours, 7 days plus, before we hit the actual turn of the seasons coming on through. Last day of summer on Friday will be living up to its name. Temperatures very close to where we should be for this time of the year. And unfortunately, we've got to ramp up the possibility of more showers and thunderstorms. So Friday night football, again, could be in jeopardy in some parts of the Mid-South, but this is still several days away, so we're going to have to watch and see what goes on there. First end of the week and into the first week itself of autumn, temperatures again taking a little bit of a dive. Now, I've kind of taken a less optimistic approach here. There are some computer models, not a great deal of them, but some of them into the beginning part of autumn have noticed a cold front approaching, and I've dropped the numbers here relatively well back in the lower 80s. It's just that this is so far in the future that a lot can happen in the near future, in the next several days. Near future is a little bit more guaranteed. It's going to be hot and humid, but as we go toward this next week, I've cooled the numbers off here, but not as much as some of the computer models are showing. So some of them are showing upper 60s for highs. I'm very wishful for that, but I'm thinking right now mainly possibly mid to upper 70s to lower 80s. That could change, though, in the next several days, so definitely want to keep it tuned to News Channel 3 on air and online. It will keep you updated on those forecasts out there. Once again, we've got a couple of systems. That failed one over Texas, no longer even organized, just kind of spinning around out there, and Florence has barely moved in the last 30 hours, barely going west at 2 miles per hour right along the Carolina coast. Showers, thunderstorms, tornadoes, all kinds of fun stuff, including feet worth of rainfall, just incredible huge amounts of showers and thunderstorms out there, as we see again for the course of the next couple of days. Not going to be going anyplace at this point in time. Jeff Frog Wheeler, can I get a thunderstorm to go to Oxford? Bama is killing Ole Miss. Sorry to hear that for the Ole Miss fans. Unfortunately, we can't really schedule stuff like that. This is not my table, but I'll see what I can do. It's going to involve a lot of root beer, I'll tell you that much for right now. Good evening to everybody else checking in for this evening, and thanks everybody for watching for tonight. Chances of this storm system really leaving the East Coast is not going to be happening anytime soon. It will be a tropical depression. Tropical storm right now, winds barely at tropical storm strength. If it drops below 39 miles per hour, it becomes a tropical depression, and then it just wanders back into eastern Tennessee. Could be a little breezy around this area, but doesn't look like anything involving hurricane force winds. And then eventually it looks like it is going to be making its way back up and through New England, just as a large storm system going on through, not anything else at this point in time. So good news on that. Now, we do have a couple of other things to talk about for right now. Again, that failed system over the Northwest Gulf, Florence, we've talked about that. Couple more systems going on, one of which has fallen apart as well. Isaac has now basically just withered away. A Hurricane Hunter plane was sent to investigate this morning. It had no structure. It had no cohesion. Strength was falling. It was not looking good. So Isaac is basically toast at this point in time. Meanwhile, way out into the Atlantic, after coming in from off of Africa, you've got Helene making its way back toward the north and to the east. What's left of Isaac might wander into the Gulf of Mexico. Again, Florence curving its way back to the northeast. If you're heading toward Great Britain in the next couple of days, this storm could be a bit of a problem, as in maybe some inclement weather, windy, colder, and maybe a lot more rainfall for parts of the British Isles. So something, again, to see into and around that area. But so far, nothing else is developing in the eastern Atlantic. So very good news for anything else going on into and around the area there. Ione Duvalli, hope I'm saying that right. What's the update in Jacksonville, North Carolina? Is it also flooding? They picked up anywhere between a foot to 18 inches of rainfall, and this again is where we've been looking at some pretty ugly conditions out across portions of the area. As long as this storm continues to sit in place, it's going to continue to drop a lot of rainfall, bringing it onshore. So anything in the Carolinas, especially the eastern half of the Carolinas, that's where we see, again, that potential for the very heavy rainfall to continue for probably about the next at least 24, maybe even 48 hours, possibly longer, if this storm does not decide to kind of kick in gear and make its way on out of the area. So we're just not seeing too much of anything in the way of hope for this leaving on soon. Now, again, if you have any, again, ideas about going back this direction, heading home, please wait. Do not go rushing back toward the Carolinas anytime soon, because once again, you got road damage, you got debris, you got power lines down, you got massive amounts of flooding going on. And again, there's health concerns with that, as well as structural and safety concerns. So not the best idea to go rushing on through. Wait for the authorities, local government, to say all is clear. come on back. For right now, best idea for safety's sake is just to stay where you are, stick around the Mid-South for a few more days, and wait. We'll let you know about that when we get that information, so stick around for a lot more there. Louis Haskett, frequent contributor to our Weather Pictures program from Northeast Arkansas. Good sunrise this morning with Skip the Weather Pup out and about from early on, so thank you guys for getting up early for that one. From Reb Alert, the emergency alert system for the Ole Miss campus, I happened to post a picture on Friday of the temperature for Friday afternoon back in the 90s, heat index in about the mid to upper 90s, somewhere in there, and this is what they sent back, a nice little summary of too hot, and that's how it feels out there. Mallory Thompson, welcome if you're back in Montana. Thanks for sticking around right now, and thanks for tuning in for tonight. Mallory used to be one of our production department people here at News Channel 3, so welcome back to the show for this evening. And Fred Style 88, also from the Ole Miss campus, sunrise from this morning from the Ford Center, looking back towards sunrise, beautiful view from Oxford, Mississippi this morning. If you've got weather pictures, we want to see them so we can show them either here on our netcast or also on our newscast as well. Tweet them to me, Aonic_WREG3, link them to me on Instagram, post them on my Facebook page, or you can email me again at austin.onek@wreg.com. Check out my forecast throughout the rest of the weekend. You can get it many different ways. Country 92.5 and Oldies 102.3. Weather on the radio throughout the rest of the weekend. And don't forget to download our News Channel 3 weather app. It's available at your particular app store. Just search WREG and download that today. Coming up in just about half an hour or so, on my Facebook page, we're going to take a look at weather where the troops are. So if you have friends or loved ones serving in the United States military around the world, we'll take a look at some of the various locations that, again, close to weather reporting sites, so you can see a little bit more about what's going on. Coming up tonight on News Channel 3 at 10, we'll have, again, a possibility of, again, some more thunderstorms in the forecast. We'll take a look at that as an updated forecast coming up here into and around the area. Alex T. Freeman, let us not rule out earthquakes and tsunamis as the sun shines straight on the equator. Yeah, doesn't really look like a thing happening, but it's a good theory anyway. As of right now, again, pretty quiet in the Mid-South. We'll give you more details about the forecast tonight at 10. Megan Rice has all the day's news, all the day's sports. Kristen Holloway has all the day's news, and of course, yours truly with your forecast. And I'll have more coming up tomorrow morning on News Channel 3 Daybreak. Again, if you have any questions, suggestions, concerns, complaints, if you absolutely must, again, you can email me and I'll send them along to my powers that be, and we'll get you information on that right there, austin.onek@wreg.com. And thanks to everybody for tuning in for Weather Overtime for Saturday night. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, I'm meteorologist Austen Onek. Thanks for joining us for tonight's edition, and stick around for a lot more with News Channel 3 on air and online throughout the rest of the last weekend of summer 2018.